Okay, good day guys, welcome to today's lesson on Staad Pro Connect edition. In today's lesson we are going to be talking about how load is being transferred, especially lateral load. So now we have this simple frame. Now this length is 3 meters and this is also 3 meters. Now this is 3 meters and the height, each of the height is also 3 meters. It is fully pinned, the base is fully pinned, whilst the beam and coulomb connection is pinned to a simply is fixed rather. In this case, it is fixed. So what we have now is we've assigned a simple property just for uniform EI, which is 300 millimeter by 300 millimeter rectangular section concrete. So we've assigned this, so everything has the same elastic modulus and second moment of area. Okay, this property we have is concrete. Now for now we don't have any specifications, but the support we have is pinned. Like I've said initially, it is fully pinned. So let's go there and apply a load. So we are going to apply a load of 120 kilonewton to the center node. So let me make it in the negative direction so that we'll be able to visualize it properly. So you can see in the middle axis now, it is fully moment connected. You have a moment connection, that is a rigid connection. So we want to see how the load will be distributed within these 6 supports. Okay, the next thing we do is analysis, perform analysis, and let's run our analysis. Okay, so let's run the analysis and let's see some things we are going to notice. Okay, so we have 0 error, 0 warning, 0 knots. So click OK. Now, yes. So first thing we need to do is to check our displacement. So let's click this support. Click this support. And you can see our displacement at that support is in the Z direction is 29.8. Let's say 29.8. In this other support also, it is 29.8. Whilst in the middle support where the load is acting on the most, it is 33.52. So which we expect that. Now don't forget that where load goes more, where you have more displacement, you have more load, like we know. So let's go to the reaction and let's see what we have in our reaction. So you can see in our reaction we have the vertical 75.5. Let's say 6, and we have negative. Don't forget the load is pushing it in this direction, so it's going to come down more here. And this, whilst in the Z direction now, for the wind, we have 20.134, 20.131, 19.76. So what we have here is equal to what we have here, but the load distribution is different. Now, the reason why it is like that is because there is no diaphragm which is going to tie this building together. So let's go back to our analytical modeling and let's model a diaphragm. So modeling the diaphragm means you are putting like a slab, something that is tying these buildings together. So that means it deflects equally. So if this one deflects by 1 millimeter, this one also deflects by 1 millimeter by 1 millimeter. So all the nodes will deflect by the same distance. Okay, so let's go back there. Go back to specification, but before that we need to see our node number. So press shift N and we can see. So let's pick node 18 as the controlling node. Okay, so go there, node, and pick node 18 as so you can make it rigid as the controlling node. Okay, select it. Now I will just assign it to that particular view. Select my node cursor. Okay, I like it. Okay, so assign to selected node. Assign to selected node. Okay. Yeah, so we've assigned this. You can see the number here. So let's go now and let's choose post process. Let's run the analysis again to see what is going to give us. So now, since we've made it a rigid diaphragm, we expect that the deflection and the reaction should be equal, since everything behaves alike. Okay, now let's go to displacement. Let me select this. So selecting this, I have 28.2. I also have 28.2 and 28.2. And like I said initially, that once you have deflection, the higher the deflection, the more load it takes. So let's go to the reaction. So we believe we should have equal reaction. So we have 80-20, 80-20, 80-20, 80-20, which is according to the deflection, like I have said. So it means it works. Now let's assume we have our beams are simply supported, okay, and we have just bracing in this bay. Let's see what will happen. So let's go back there to our model and let's model a simply sub. Let's have release moments at these beams. Then we'll place diagonal bracings here, okay. So what I will do is go to specification first, create beam, partial moment release. Let's release 99% of the moment. That's at the start. And also at the end, partial moment release. Okay, 0.99. Add. Now I will select beams parallel to X and Z direction. Okay, so assign to selected beams. Assign it. Okay. Then also this assign to selected beams. Assign. Okay. Now the next thing I want to do is to make it easy for me. I just want to model a diagonal member. So I'll select this. Okay. Just draw a line like this and let me release the moment on it. So I'll press escape on my keyboard, select this beam. Okay, assign to selected beams, assign, and also this, assign to selected beams, assign. Okay, so what I'll just do is copy and paste. Paste beam. So I'm going what? Minus 3, because I'm going down. So we have that. Okay. So the properties have not been assigned. I will just use the same property just for this example, assigned to view. Okay. So let's go now to our post processing. So don't forget we still have the diaphragm assigned. So we believe that the floor should deflect equally, but let's see what we the bracing creates. Now we have a load of 120 at this joint. Let's look at our deflection displacement. Select this. We have a displacement of 0 point, and we have a displacement here of 45 and a displacement here of 91. Now the reason why is because here the load comes. Let's see the reaction so you understand why. So you can see in this in the Z direction we have 0.169, whilst here we have 62, here we have 9, and here we have 19. So you can see what we have. So indirectly the bracing is taking the load more to this support. So this B is taking more of the load. So let's see what will happen if I transfer this bracing. I have double bracing, one here and one at the other direction. So also you can also notice that this bay is stiffer than the remaining bay. That's why this bay is taking more load. So let me transfer this bracing to this third bay. Okay, so let's run our analysis now. Let's see what effect we are going to have. Okay, so post processing. Yes, we have that. Okay, so let's say our displacement. Select this. We have a displacement of 0.6 or 0.7, 0.7 and 0.7. So what we have for our displacement. And what we noticed was that it is balanced because we have the same stiffness. We have equal stiffness here and here, so it's going to be balanced. But in previous case, we had more stiffness here, and here is going to displace less because of the bracing. So this is what we have. And let's see the reaction. So our reaction, we have 59, and you can see it's Z direction 59 and Z direction 59. So the reason why this is not taking much is because this is stiffer, and the bracing's duty is to take lateral load. Okay. So we've seen that already. Now another thing we can do again is to create a shear wall. Okay. So we are going to create a very simple shear wall, and we'll see the effects of it again. Okay, so let's go to analytical modeling. So I'm going to select my bracings and delete them. So I've copied the wall down, but what I need to do is to delete the columns by the edges. Okay. So next thing I need to do now is to assign the support. Okay, but now I will assign before I do that, I need to mesh the plate. So select plate cursor. Highlight geo structure, right click, generate plate mesh. Let me use the division as 5 just for simplicity. Okay, so we've done this now. Next thing I need to do is to assign the thickness of our wall. And let's say our wall's thickness is going to be 0.3. Let's just make it 0.3. Okay, so I'll assign it to view since that's what it is. Assign to view. Next thing is the support. And like I've said, or like it's known initially, that shear wall is like a cantilever wall, so the base are always fixed, so that it can transfer the lateral when the wind comes in this direction, it transfers it down to the base in the form of movement, tension, and compression. So that is why we are fixing the base. So I'll create new support, fixed, add, then go to the front view. So I'll go to the front view, highlight this node here. Highlight this node here also. Okay. Create new view. And I just assign the fix to view. Okay. So this is the fixed support. Assign it to view. So assign it to view. Okay, so display structure. And let's go back to the beginning. So you can see it's fixed here. It's this here. And also our loading is still the same as this. Okay. So let's go to the post processing and let's see effect of the shear wall structure. So 0.01 0.0. Okay. So let's see what our displacement is at this corner. Select this. This is node 16. We have Z of minus. Now you can see it's reduced from the bracing. So this is 0.3, this is another 0.3, and this is 0.3. So because the shear wall is more stiffer, so that's right. Now let's look at the reaction, what the middle bay will take. So you remember that our middle bay, the load is at this side, so you can see the Z direction very, very negligible. In fact, it is not taking any wind load. So majority of the lateral load is taken by the shear wall. So once you select, let me select that point and let's look at the reaction. Okay, that note. So select the reaction. So once you select it, you'll be able to see it. So you can see what that particular node is taking. It's taking 8.5. Let me select it here too again, and we can see it's 8.5. So we can see the difference between a moment frame, a braced frame, and a frame with shear wall. So thank you for watching today's video on Staad Pro. If you have any question, you can drop it in the comment section.